Find the error bound in approximating the given quantity with a third degree Taylor polynomial for f of x about x equals 0. So we're supposed to approximate this quantity using the Taylor polynomial at x equals 0 for this function. So what x value would that be that would produce this quantity? So I set the function equal to this, and I see easily by inspection that x is equal to 2. 2 goes down there if you expect this to be 1 over square root of 3. So that's the 2. That's where we're evaluating the function at to get this quantity. So I go through my error bound typical things. I get my derivatives up to the n plus 1, which is the fourth derivative. And I get this quantity. And it'd be interesting for you to see if you could write this quantity down in a general term notation, but you'd have to handle this. So I'll show that at the end. Anyway, so your error for the third degree Taylor polynomial is less than the m over the n plus 1 factorial x to the fourth. The reason why it's just x is it's actually x minus 0, because we're centering the Taylor polynomial at x equals 0, so it's just x. And we're bounding that error on the interval 0 to 2, because 2 is what was found there. So m is the max value of the fourth derivative of x on this, and the fourth derivative is this function right here. And that's maximized when the denominator is the smallest it can be. Denominator smallest. So that is when x equals 0. When x equals 0, this fraction is the largest it can be. And that is when you plug in x equals 0, you get 105/16. So that's what m is. But x to the fourth is maximized on this interval at the biggest it can be, which is at 2. So the final result is that the error is bounded by m, which is this, over n plus 1 factorial, that's 4 factorial, 2 to the 4th, which is 105/16, 4 factorial times 2 to the 4th, which is 16. So the 16's cancel out, you divide everything, and you get this, 4.375. So here's a check. This is the function. I went to Wolfram Alpha and found out that P3 is equal to this. And P3 at 2, evaluating there, is x equals 2, is going to produce these numbers here by just plugging in, and that equals negative 1. In a more complicated case, you could do it this way. Put the function into y1 and do a second calc value and put the number in x equals 2, and sure enough, you get the same thing. So, and f of 2 is, of course, the value that we're trying to approximate, 1 over square root of 3. So the error at x equals 2 is the subtraction there, which is the 1 over square root of 3, and our approximation by P3 is way off. It's negative 1. So the error is 1.57735. But the error bound max was 4.375. So this error that we got for the actual area is indeed less than the error bound. So that checks out. And here's a picture of what's happening. This is the function f of x. This is the p3 of x. It fits it for a while, but by the time you get to 2, and you get this p3 is negative 1, and the function value is right way up here. So that's a pretty bad error there. So the actual error is this. So hence, p3 of x is not a very good estimator of 1 over square root of 3 when your Taylor polynomial is centered at 0. If it was centered at close to 2, it would have been a better approximation. Or if you had a higher degree of the Taylor polynomial, it would have been better. And another thing that's interesting about this problem is the pattern that's building up here on these coefficients. So, but how do you represent a sort of odd factorial, like 7 times 5 times 3 times 1? So here's how you do it. You take 7 factorial and you write it all the way out. Then you realize that's 7, 5, 3, 1. 7, 5, 3, 1. And the rest of it's 6, 4, 2. Then you realize that you can factor out a 2 out of each one of these here. 6, 4, 2 to get 3, 2, 1. And there's a 2 out of each one. There's 3 2s. So it's 2 to the third times 3 times 2 times 1. So in other words, 7 factorial is equal to this odd factorial times 2 to the third times 3 factorial. So if you divide over by 2 to the third 3 factorial, you get your 7 times 5 times 3 times 1. So this odd factorial can be written this way. Okay. So then, when you go to write your general term for your derivative, you just match everything up to what it has to be. Like this is 2k plus 1, you know, it was 4, so that's 8 plus 1 is 9. You got the negative, it's all of them are divided by 2. And you put in your odd factorial, which is this, 2k minus 1. You match it up to the derivative number, and you get this, and this. And then you have the 2 to the k down there, the way it was. Simplify that a little bit, and you get this. The general term of the polynomial is now this divided by k factorial, which is this, which comes out simplified to this. So those are the terms of your Taylor polynomial.